G'day, I'm Brett. Today I'll be installing a dual battery system. I'll be using a Blue Sea Systems automatic charging relay, which is rated to 500 amps continuous and 2500 amps cranking capacity. This is more than sufficient for combining the two batteries to jumpstart your vehicle, or for combining them for winching operations. This unit comes with an in-dash mountable switch, which can be used to combine or disconnect the batteries at will, and it has a backup toggle switch on top, which you can use to manually disconnect. I'll be using a 120 amp hour AGM deep cycle battery for powering all my accessories in the fridge, and I've manufactured a dual battery tray out of 3mm plate steel and 25mm RHS. So this should be a really good unit. I'll put it all in and see how we go. As I said, my battery tray I made is made out of 3mm plate steel, 25mm RHS welded on the bottom. This fits into the gap in the base of your Land Rover battery box. And then a couple of tabs for bolting through the top into the tray to hold it down. And I made a couple of clamps for bolting down the batteries.
The battery tray is installed, and the control wires soldered and insulated. The dash mounted switch wires are connected, and the switch installed. The relay unit is installed, and then the batteries. The Blue Sea Systems relay can manually disconnect or reconnect the batteries. The control switch can be left on auto, which connects the batteries when charging is detected, or manually connected or disconnected. Now I've made a sandwich of carpet, foam and rubber to replace the original metal cover, as the battery contacts are now too high for the original to slide on. I also installed an Anderson plug, which allows me to connect accessories without removing the seat cover. It's rated up to 50 amps.